رمضان فرصة العمر ونور في مدى الدهر ويحكي رقة النهر ففيه ليلة القدر منير في أماسينا وذا يمحو مآسينا ويسري في مناقينا ومنه رونق الفجر فما الصبر
May I have your listening and attentive hearts. هو النبي وهذه أنواره هو ذا الرسول وهذه أسراره أثر أثار الشوق في أرواحنا فإذا تبدى تنجلي الظلمات أثر تنال المكرمات بسره فبسر طه تنزل البركات شعر النبي فهم به متبركا تأتيك منه بسره النفحات Oh, messenger of Allah, if the camel came sobbing to you, sensing your compassion, if for your touch even a dead trunk had shown passion, if to your command a tree trenched the ground, if to your voice no ear had heard a more pleasant sound, if your index pointed to the sky split a moon of shining light, if the wipe of your honorable hand returned a severed eye back to its sight, Muhammad, if by the mention of your name the hearts of men had fluttered, what with the presence of a piece of yours here tonight, in which language will this love be uttered? Let us all welcome a blessed prophetic relic, a piece of the hair of our master, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accompanied by a group of dignified sheikhs. دعونا نستقبل معا أثرا من الآثار النبوية الشريفة
بمواكبة ثلة من المشايخ الكرام وفريق النوبة.
صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Peace and blessings be upon you, O Messenger of Allah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Muhad Sidawi, and tonight I am honored to be your MC. First, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Her Excellency, the Honorable Margaret Beasley, ACKC, Governor of New South Wales, His Eminence, Sheikh Ibrahim Al-Shafi'i, Darul Fatwa, the Islamic High Council of Australia, Mr. Muhammad Mahyar, the President of the Islamic Charitable Projects Association, Bassam Al-Khattab, the Ambassador of Iraq, Scouts Commissioner, Police, Religious Leaders, Consuls, Ambassadors, Councillors, Ministers, Imams, and Community Leaders. I would like to welcome you all to this magnificent celebration, the Multicultural Mawlid Concert, the celebration that Muslims eagerly await for each year. The light of guidance has shone upon us, shedding light and pleasure over the universe in the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, the month of the birth of the best of all creations, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We would like to start our program here tonight with a beautiful recitation of the Holy Quran by Brother Ahmed Al-Khair. Please let us give him a warm welcome.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولا شاهداً ومبشراً ونذيراً
When young seeds are planted in pure, abundant soil, they blossom to flourish in the face of this world, giving it back more richness than before. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you a garden of these rich flowers. Please join me in welcoming the Muslim Kids Club, who have put together a special performance for us all today. Please make them all feel welcome.
Thank you.
MashaAllah, that was a truly beautiful performance. Let us all give them another round of applause. We will now leave you with another group of wonderful children who have also prepared an amazing presentation for you all. Please let us welcome the Kids Club, but this time in Arabic.
again.
Round of applause.
One more time. That was the wrong chant. Apologies for that. We will now be starting again for the last time. Round of applause to encourage the boys and girls on stage. We got there in the end, and I'm sure we can all appreciate the time and effort that the boys and girls have put into making this a beautiful, beautiful performance. So once again, a very warm round of applause for the Kids Club. This stunning community response to the Mawlid celebration witnessed here today reflects in a small way the worldwide rush of Muslims to celebrate the commemoration of the Mawlid. Each culture adorning their celebrations in their own colour and taste. Muslims of every race, colour, age, gender gather on this occasion, just as you have all gathered here today to celebrate this blessed event. To speak more about the importance of this event to Muslims, I would like to call upon Sheikh Ibrahim from Darul Fatwa, the Islamic High Council of Australia.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إني شربت الحب من نبع الهوى. إني شربت الحب من نبع الهوى وجعلت حب المصطفى ترياقي. يا تاج رسل الله إني هائم والقلب يحكي لوعة المشتاق فمتى تصير الروح عند مقامكم لتطيب نفسي بعد طول فراقي محمدي محمدي في الهوى أعلنتها لمحمد حبي وله أشواقي الحمد لله الملك الديان العزيز المنان الموجود أزلا وأبدا بلا مكان خالق الإنس والملائكة والجان إظهار لشرف أعظم إنسان سيدنا محمد بدر الدجى وشمس الأكوان صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبع هداهم وسار على نهجهم بإحسان أما بعد أي لقاء عظيم هذا الذي جمع الآلاف المؤلفة بلغاتهم المختلفة وقلوبهم المؤتلفة جاءوا من شتى الآفاق تحركهم المشاعر والأشواق تعظيماً وتقديراً وحباً لصاحب الذكرى من بعثه الله ليتمم مكارم الأخلاق اجتمعوا تحت شعار هذا العام سيرة النبي محمد نهج حياة سيرة النبي محمد أسمعوني نهج حياة سيرة النبي محمد سيرة النبي محمد سيرة
a surge of light, brighter than the sun and stars. It gave sight to hearts and remedy to the deepest scars. From ashes it lifted a civilization of glory, passing down a realm of knowledge by authentic chains, not fictional story. A surge of light brighter than sun and star, a luminance of mercy stretching so far, bidding lawful and forbidding crime. A surge of light piercing the darkness through our time. Dear brothers and sisters of faith, Allah the exalted and clear of all imperfections has greatly glorified the rank of his Prophet Muhammad and has raised it to the highest levels and made him the best of all in mannerism and appearance. And he swore by the life of Muhammad, though he had not sworn by the life of anyone before him. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was characterized by good qualities, including honesty, trustworthiness, connecting with kin, chastity, generosity, courage, obedience to Allah in every matter, time, moment, and breath. As well, he presented brilliant eloquence, proper advice, kindness, compassion, goodness, and offered sympathy for the poor, the orphan, the widow, and the weak. He was the humblest of people. All this alongside possessing an impeccable reputation, an appealing image, and a noble ancestry. Here we all are, a magnificent crowd of various languages and colors, joyously gathered today to commemorate the birth of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and to show praise to our Lord for the great virtue of his birth. We all came together to say, we love you, O Messenger of Allah. Your life story is a way of life. And this is the slogan for this Mawlid. Your life story is, say, a way of life. Your life story is, your life story is, your life story is. Imam Muslim narrated from the root of Jarir ibn Abdullah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever innovates a good innovation in Islam will receive its reward and a similar reward of those who practice it until the day of judgment without the lessening of their rewards. And whoever innovates an innovation of misguidance will carry its sin and a similar sin of those who practice it until the day of judgment without the lessening of their sins. This hadith is a foundation for providing the validity of the good innovations in Islam. Some people falsely claim that anything that was innovated after the Prophet, peace be upon him, is an innovation of misguidance. The statement contradicts the saying of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and it contradicts the practice of the companions and the followers until our days. Among the good innovations which complies with the religion is celebrating the birth of the Prophet in the month of Rabiul Awwal. It was initiated hundreds of years after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it was not opposed by the scholars. The honorable, knowledgeable, and righteous ruler, Al-Muzaffar, the king of Erbil, city in the country of present-day Iraq, initiated this practice about 900 years ago, and he was praised by Muslim scholars of Islam, among them the Egyptian Hafiz Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani and Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. Those who object to commemorating the Prophet's birth have no basis for their claim. They say the Prophet did not do it. And how many matters the Prophet did not do, and Muslim scholars have practiced throughout Islamic history. From compiling the Quran in a Mus'haf as Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, gathering the people for Taraweeh prayer in congregation, as Umar radiallahu anhu did, adding a second azan for the Friday prayer, as Uthman radiallahu anhu did, placing the dots for the alphabets in the Quran, making the mihrab and the minarets for the mosque and many others. The righteous predecessors are those who followed them, and those who followed them are the people of the truth, who clear Allah from any resemblance to His creation. But those who object to the Mawlid are the ones who liken Allah to His creation and claim that Allah is a body sitting on the throne and that He has limbs and organs, although Allah the Exalted says, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, which means nothing resembles Allah in any way whatsoever. Imam Ali radiallahu anhu said, Allah exists without a place before and after creating the places. He also said, Allah created the Arsh, the grand throne, as an indication of His power, and not to take it as a place to sit on it. So do not listen to them, rather show your ultimate love to your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and commemorate his birth as Muslims around the world do. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
In celebration of spring, birds have made their way from every continent to migrate towards the southern hemisphere, gliding above oceans, ascending above clouds, touching the peaks of mountains and the pits of valleys, crossing oceans, air and land, before slowing down to settle here on our stage tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you a performance of a kind. Muslims from around the world who have gathered to celebrate the birth of our Prophet and Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indonesian, Malaysian, Bosnian, English, Pakistani, Sudanese, African, and Iraqi. Ladies and gentlemen, a roar of applause for a truly spectacular performance. I introduce to you the International Chanting Band.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, there are some technical difficulties. Thank you very much for your patience. I promise this is a spectacular performance. I've seen it. But maybe just a bit more patience. Round of applause for all the performers who have done a lot of effort to put this all together. Thank you very much. Your patience is much appreciated.
Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. سعدية نسأل رب الثبات عليها هي
sure we can all agree that was a spectacular performance, and I hope you all enjoyed it as much as I did. We are very privileged to have another very special guest with us here tonight, who has come all the way from Lebanon to join us in this Less celebration. With his heartfelt love for the Prophet, he writes his poems. Poems that should be written with gold water. A world-renowned sheikh, linguist, and Arabic poet, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to His Eminence, Sheikh Ghanem Jalloul.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إخواننا أهنئكم فردا فردا لمناسبة ولادة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهناك سؤال وطلب. اسمعونا يا إخوان. هل تحبون محمداً؟ هل تحبون محمداً؟ صلوا وسلموا على رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله بارئ الخلائق ومولاهم الذي جعلهم شعوبا وقبائل ليتعارفوا وحكم بأن أكرمهم عنده أتقاهم والصلاة والسلام على سيد الناس وأعلاهم وأجملهم وأجودهم وأسماهم الذي أصبح بنوره سوق الليل في أم القرى صبح الهداية الهداية للعالمين وهداهم في الثاني عشر من ربيع الأول في ذاك الربيع الأول تغيرت الدنيا وازدهرت الأرض واستحال حال الكون إلى الهدى وتحول بعد ظلام الجاهلية تلألأت الأنوار المحمدية وبعد ركوع للأصنام والسجود استفاقت القلوب إلى طاعة المعبود المستحق للعبادة على قواعد التنزيه والتوحيد إنه محمد السيد السند المؤيد إنه محمد النبي الرسول الممجد صلى الله عليه وسلم جاء إلى الدنيا فأرسى فيها العدل وأحيا الموءودة وأكمل اليتيم وأطعم الفقير وأغاث الملهوف وأعان الضعيف وجبر كسر المسكين وأمر بمكارم الأخلاق ونهى عن الشر والمنكر حتى ملأ الدنيا لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر نعم يا سادة إنه خاتم النبيين وإمام المرسلين جاء بما جاءوا به من الدين أمر باتباع الإسلام كما أمروا بالذات فدينه واحد ويختلف بينهم أحكام في شرائعهم الأمهات فكأنهم إخوة لعلات لكنهم كانوا دعاة إلى الحق وإلى أفضل نهج في الحياة دعوتهم السلام والأمان والطمأنينة والسكينة والصلاح والرشاد وكل ما فيه خير للعباد فقال نوح لقومه إني لكم نذير مبين ألا تعبدوا إلا الله
إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم أليم. وقال شعيب لقومه وإني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم محيط. وقال موسى لأخيه لا تخف. وقال الله تعالى عن سيدنا يحيى عليه السلام: يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا وحنانا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقيا وبرا بوالديه ولم يكن جبارا عصيا. وسلام عليه يوم ولد ويوم يموت ويوم يبعث حيا. ونادى جبريل مريم عليها السلام: ألا تحزني. وقال الله تعالى إخبارا عن سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام: قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا وبرا بوالدتي ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا. فالسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا. وقال إبراهيم: يا أبت إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن. وقال يوسف لأخيه: فلا تبتئس بما كانوا يعملون. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأبي بكر: لا تحزن إن الله معنا. هذه دعوة الأنبياء جميعا. سلام في الدنيا من الشرور لأمان في الآخرة، من النعيم لأمان في الآخرة من العذاب. دعوتهم طمأنينة قلوب الصالحين بالتوكل على الله وسكينة النفوس في تسليم الأمور إلى الله. سلام على أنبياء الله والصلوات والرحمات. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I please have your attention. مدح الرسول عبادة وتقرب لله فاسعوا للمدائح واطربوا فبمدحه البركات تنزل جمة وبمدحه مر الحناجر يعذبوا. The time has come. The time has come to welcome to the stage one more very special guest, an international chanter who has circled the world praising the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Brother Muhammad Al-Fayed with the chanting band of the Islamic Charitable Project Association.
ردد على سمعي حديث محمد